हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वंस अगेन वेलकम टू योर फेवरेट फार्मा चैनल राम फार्मा एकेडमी। मायसेल्फ मिस्टर रामराव फड, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट महाराष्ट्र कॉलेज ऑफ फार्मेसी निलंगा। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट सिंथेसिस ऑफ फिनाइलेफ्रेन। इट इज स्पेशली इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर बी फार्मेसी सेकेंड ईयर स्टूडेंट्स इन सेमेस्टर 4। फर्स्ट लेट्स चेक वेदर यू नो द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ फिनाइलेफ्रेन। इज दिस द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ फिनाइलेफ्रेन? इफ योर आंसर इज येस, देन इट्स रॉन्ग, बिकॉज द स्ट्रक्चर शोन हियर is the epinephrine, which is also known as adrenaline. If you remove this para hydroxyl group from the epinephrine, then it becomes the phenylephrine. So let's remove this para hydroxyl group first. Now after removal of this hydroxyl group, the structure is the phenylephrine. Now you know the structure of phenylephrine. Let's see how to give the IUPAC name. First you have to give the numbering like this: 1 2 3 4 5 6 to the benzene ring. Start the numbering from the carbon where hydroxyl group is attached. Then give the numbering to the side chain like 1 and 2. Start the numbering from the hydroxyl group again. Now we'll see how to give the IUPAC name. This R is for the stereochemistry of this stereocenter or asymmetric center or chiral center at the carbon number 1 in the side chain. Here the stereochemistry or the configuration is R. Then this 3. 3 is the position of this side chain at the benzene ring, 3. Then 1 hydroxy for this hydroxyl group at the one or the first position. Then 2 methyl amino. Here on the second position you can see 1 methyl amino group is present, therefore 2 methyl amino. Then ethyl for this ethylene linkage, 1 and 2 carbon containing alkane is known as ethane, therefore ethyl. And the suffix is phenol, because this parent molecule or structure is the phenol. So this is the IUPAC name of phenylephrine. In the same way, I have already discussed the structure and IUPAC names of the drugs acting on adrenergic system like adrenergic agonist and anti-adrenergic drugs. Please watch those videos also. Links are given in the description. Now let's see what is phenylephrine. Phenylephrine is a selective alpha 1 adrenergic agonist. The alpha 1 adrenergic receptors are GQ coupled receptors, which are mainly found on the vascular smooth muscles. Means they are present on smooth muscles of various blood vessels. When agonist binds with alpha 1 receptor, it leads to the vasoconstriction. And I think all of you know the relation between the vasoconstriction and the blood pressure. As the vasoconstriction increases, it increases the blood pressure. And the agent or the agonist which increases the pressure on the blood vessels are also known as vasopressor agent. So in this way, phenylephrine is also used as a vasopressor agent in hypotension. In hypotension, we require to increase the blood pressure. And vasopressor agent increases the blood pressure by vasoconstriction. Then the important use of phenylephrine is as a nasal decongestant. Nasal decongestants are used to treat nasal congestion. Nasal decongestants are applied to nasal passages to reduce the congestion and discomfort due to the allergies and the common cold. Phenylephrine causes blood vessels in the nasal passages to shrink, that means vasoconstrict. So in this way, phenylephrine relieves the congestion in the nose. It is also used as a madriatic. Madriasis is the dilation of pupil of eye. Here phenylephrine binds with the alpha 1 receptors present on the iris dilator muscle, which stimulates the dilator muscle for the dilation of pupil. And the importance of phenylephrine is it produces madriasis without affecting the accommodative ability of the eye, that is cycloplegia. That means phenylephrine produces madriasis without the cycloplegia. Now students, you know that phenylephrine causes the constriction of vascular smooth muscles, and hence it is often used in the treatment of hemorrhoids also, presumably to narrow the swollen veins and relieve the attendant pain. Phenylephrine is also used to treat the priapism. Priapism is a persistent penile erection that continues hours beyond in the absence of stimulation or after stimulation has ended. Phenylephrine is diluted with normal saline and injected directly into the corpora cavernosa. Here, the drug causes the constriction of blood vessels entering into the penis, thus causing the decreased blood flow and relieving the priapism. So these are the few important uses of phenylephrine, like vasopressor agent in hypotension, nasal decongestant, madriatic, in the treatment of hemorrhoids and in the treatment of priapism. Now after discussion of uses of phenylephrine, we are going to discuss about the synthesis part. But before moving forward, let me tell you one thing. I have seen videos on YouTube where they are teaching something wrong. Like they are starting the reaction with phenol with the chloroacetyl chloride and shows the product like this 3-hydroxy-2-chloroacetophenone. But actually this product is not possible, or it forms in very negligible amount. So it cannot be used as a pathway for the phenylephrine synthesis. Because I think all of you know, or you must have learned electrophilic substitution reactions. Here this hydroxyl group is actually the electron donating group, and these electron donating groups acts as ortho para directors. Means the product form will be on this ortho or para position and not on the meta position. Here product shown is on the meta position. Here you can see this is the meta position, and this product forms in very negligible amount. So what actually the product formed during this reaction, when you react the phenol with the chloroacetyl chloride, that is another interesting point, because the major product form over here is the phenyl chloroacetate, that is the ester form, and not it is not, and the ortho or para products are also very present in the negligible amount. The major product is actually the phenyl chloroacetate, the ester compound. So friends, you don't use this starting reaction for the synthesis of phenylephrine. Now we are going to discuss about the actual synthesis of phenylephrine. You can synthesize phenylephrine with various routes. Here I am going to explain the simplest one. You can start with the starting material 3-hydroxyacetophenone. If you give the numbering to this molecule 1, 2, 3, then here you can see at the third position hydroxyl group is present, and this part is known as acetophenone. Therefore the starting material is 3-hydroxyacetophenone. Now some of you might have question how to synthesize this meta product then, because here you can see this acetyl group is present on the meta position. I will explain that about that also in the latter part. First we have to react to this 3-hydroxyacetophenone with the sulfuryl chloride SO2Cl2. This SO2Cl2 carry out the chlorination at the alpha carbon. Here you can see this is the alpha carbon which is adjacent to the carbonyl group where chlorination takes place. It is actually the selective alpha chlorination reaction and forms the product 2-chloro-1-3-hydroxyphenylethanone. Then in the next step, this chlorinated product undergoes the reaction in the presence of enzyme alcohol dehydrogenase and forms this product R3-2-chloro-1-hydroxyethylphenol. Here you can see the reaction takes place, or the conversion is actually the conversion of carbonyl group into the hydroxyl group, and the reaction takes place is the reduction reaction, because ketone is reduced into the hydroxyl group. And the important part here, you can see this hydroxyl group has only one configuration, or the most of the compound synthesized is actually the with R configuration. And we have seen already in the phenylephrine structure, phenylephrine has the more activity in the R configuration. Then in the next step, this R form of the 3-2-chloro-1-hydroxyethylphenol undergoes the reaction with the methyl amine, because in the structure of phenylephrine you have seen at the second position of the side chain methyl amino group is present. So you have to use the reagent methyl amine and forms the product, that is the desired product, phenylephrine. In the last step you can see the chlorine group and one hydrogen from the amine group is removed as the minus HCl and forms the product phenylephrine. So in this way you can synthesize the phenylephrine. The important part, or the importance of this synthetic pathway, is you don't have to use any protecting group, because in the next route you are going to see that we have to use the protecting groups. But before that we'll see how to synthesize this meta product, because I have shown you that some of them are teaching wrong how to synthesize this meta product, that we are going to discuss now. You can start with the starting material acetophenone. You have to react acetophenone with the nitrating mixture, that is the combination of concentrated HNO3 and H2SO4. Then nitration takes place at the meta position, because you know the acetyl group is the electron withdrawing group which acts as a meta director, and here you can see the nitration takes place at the meta position, because this is ortho position, then this is meta, and this one is the para position. So the nitration takes place at the meta position. Then in the next step you have to reduce this nitro group into the amino group, and that can be done in the presence of reducing agent like tin chloride. Here you can see this nitro group is converted into the amino group. Then in the next step, you have to do the diazotization reaction, and that can be done in the presence of NaNO2 and HCl, that is sodium nitrite and hydrochloric acid, and forms the diazotization product. Then in the next step, you have to react, or you have to warm this diazotization product with the water, and it converts it into the 3-hydroxyacetophenone that can be used in the synthesis of phenylephrine. So in this way, you can synthesize this meta product. So for the synthesis of meta product, you have to go through the multiple steps. As I have already told you that phenylephrine can be synthesized with various routes, here I am going to provide you the second route of synthesis of phenylephrine. Here, the protecting groups are used during the synthesis of phenylephrine. I am not going to explain the mechanism of reaction because the video is getting longer. If you want to write in the examination, you can use the route 1 because it is the simplest one. Okay friends, so this is the synthesis of phenylephrine. In next video, we are going to discuss about the synthesis of salbutamol. If you like the video, please like and share the video with all your friends. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel. It helps our channel to grow. Thanks for watching. Goodbye. Take care.